Hey friends, my name is Dylan Bates. I'm just breaking into the tutorial game. Today I just wanted to give you a quick tutorial showing you one of Final Cut Pro's best coloring tools that I think is extremely underrated. Oftentimes in low budget productions, we have to shoot around what we've got, and sometimes in your scene there's a bright red ugly car in the background. There's nothing you can do about it, so you just have to shoot and hope you can fix it in post. So today, I wanted to show you a really fast and easy way to change the color of any object in your frame without destroying the rest of your clip. And I got this shot for free from pexels.com. I'm not sponsored by them or anything, but they have thousands of free clips and photos and stuff that are royalty free, and I super recommend that you go check them out if you get the chance. I'll have a free download to this very clip so you can work along with me if you so desire. Very quickly, I'm going to balance the exposure on this shot. If you don't want to watch this part, you can just skip to the time code that's on the screen now. So to get started, we are going to go on up here to View, Show in Viewer, Video Scopes. And another really fast way for that is Command 7. Okay, so the video scopes can look a little intimidating at first, but they're really not too bad. If your video scopes don't look like this, where it says Luma in the top left and it looks like this weird waveform, I'll show you how to change that real quick. So we'll just go up here to where it looks like singular, raising the bar. And we'll go down and click on waveform. And then you can click again and move on down to Luma. And that will get you looking just like this. And if you have like multiples up like this, you can click on view and go to the square, and that'll just show us the Luma. So from there, we are going to select our clip and come on over here to the right to the effects panel, and we will click and drag the color board onto our clip. And you'll see that it added the color board feature up here. So to edit our actual grade, we're gonna click on the rainbow icon there. And it looks like it already opened us up to exposure, but if it's not set on exposure, you can just click over there. And that'll get us started for the next step. So in the scopes, you can see there's this bright white line right around the 70 mark. Now that line is representing what's going on here in the sky where the highlights are blown out. And it seems to me that the person who made this shot, it's a beautiful shot, but they put a LUT on it or something that brought the highlights way down, and they're probably trying to go for the filmic look or something like that. But my personal preference is to make this as bright as we can, bright and vibrant, but not over the top so that our highlights are totally destroyed. So to fix this, what we're gonna do is come over here to the exposure panel. And as I click and drag, you can see that line here moving up and down as I raise the exposure. Now my personal preference is to get that sun as close to the 100 mark, get the sky nice and bright. We don't wanna lose additional detail that's already been lost in the sky, but we'll get it as close as we can. And that'll just add a lot of brightness to this image. And then down here, you can see this zero mark, and that's where our shadows are gonna fall. Now there's a few points in this image that are black, and a lot of people like the washed out blacks. That's a trendy style right now, but I prefer to keep them real nice and contrasty, and we're just gonna barely bring those blacks down, and it's just gonna add the contrast we need, and you'll just notice it's barely touching that zero. I'll even bring them up a little bit. And that's gonna give us the contrast that we need for this shot. Now there's also the midtones, and you can adjust those however you like. However, I like how they're falling in this shot. I think it's got a real nice sunset glow to it. Now that our clip is more or less balanced, we can move on to what I think is one of the most underrated coloring tools found in any editing software. It works in Final Cut Pro, it's also in DaVinci Resolve, Adobe, and probably many others. What we're gonna do is use the Hue Saturation curves. And they're very simple to use, but they're really, really powerful. And I think that more people should be using them because they're a really great way of getting beautiful golden tones out of your skies or anything really quickly without affecting too much else in the frame. So to do that, we're gonna go up here to the color board where there's this down arrow, click that, and move on down to the plus hue saturation curves. you'll see all these different options here. And the one we're going to focus on is this hue versus hue right now. So if we click this eyedropper, it'll allow us to pick any of the colors that are in this shot to affect them in the hue versus hue selection. So if we want to get the van here, we can just click that and it'll create these dots here. And that's it, right where we clicked, is that orange dot there. After we've done that, we can click and drag on hue versus hue, and you'll see how the colors just start to shift dramatically. And we can move these all over the place. So pretend we want this orange van to be a nice, beautiful, dark blue. All we'll do is we'll click and drag all the way up to where it's blue. Now you'll see that there's a little bit of banding in here, and this is a lower quality clip. It's not the raw stuff. So sometimes you're gonna have to deal with a little banding, but I think we can fix a little bit of this. So if we click and drag this selection out and just spread it a little bit, you'll notice the colors are working a little better. Now, unfortunately, this has just destroyed everything else in the image. All the colors are purple and blue and whatever color. Her hair looks like she just dyed it. So we're gonna fix that. Okay, so to do that, we're gonna come up here to the hue saturation curves, and you'll see this square rectangular thing with a circle inside of it. And that is a shape mask. So we are going to add a shape mask. And as I do that, you'll notice that just the part of the mask that's covering the car is blue, but it leaves everything else totally okay. So we're just gonna move this right over the top of the car, and we're gonna click and drag, and we're just gonna shape it to the side of the car here using these green handles. And after we've done that, we can square it out, or rectangle it out, I guess, by clicking that clear dot. And we'll just make it look pretty close to the shape of the car. And you can rotate and do whatever you need to do to get it where it needs to be. And this outer red box is the feather. So we can drag that and it'll have a nice feather, but obviously we don't want to affect the rest of the image. So we're just going to bring that feather in relatively close to the car, so we're not affecting too much outside of the image. And you'll notice there's still a little orange in these tires, and we'll fix that in a bit. We now have a shot where the car is blue and everything else looks normal. You would never even know that we shifted the colors. However, if we move this shot, you'll notice that our mask only stays on the car and we start to lose the edges. So we're gonna fix that really quickly. All we need to do is, I'll make sure my mask is enabled here, is we're gonna click this add keyframe button, and that'll turn yellow, and that will allow us to now animate the mask as we go. So I'll move forward about 5 seconds, and then I'll just click and drag this mask, and now it will animate with the movement of the camera. Now you'll notice I went a little crazy by going 5 seconds, so maybe do 2.5 seconds or so, and we'll just slide that back a little bit. And now we're starting to go places. So we'll just move forward again. We'll go to the 10 second mark, and we can actually scale this out, drag it over, do what we need to do to get the job done. And as you can see, the car is contained within that color shift. So we'll just keep doing that throughout the whole frame. Now, if we scroll back to the beginning, just scrub through and make sure that I didn't miss any portion of the van. And it looks like we did a pretty good job, which is awesome. Also, I think that's a camera guy there, which is cool. Good job, camera dude. Now that the car is all shifted, we also want to get these wheels. So we're going to add another shape mask, and you can add unlimited shape masks for as much as you need. Whoops, gotta just make sure I grab the right one. So I can scale that down to the tire, and it's great because it's already a circle. And maybe I'll disable this other mask. Whoops, I want to see that mask. Well, that's not working for me, so. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a keyframe and we'll slide on forward a bit, drag it, work with me. Yep, we're going for professionalism here, nailing it. Alrighty, and we'll just keep animating that on through. And nobody will be able to tell the difference. And we'll just get that last frame there. Perfect. Okay. And we can just scrub on through and make sure that we didn't miss anything on that tire. Looks like we did a good job. So we'll just do the last tire and we'll be done. Add shape mask. Scale that down. Slide it on over the tire. Perfect. And we will add the keyframe and slide forward. And this is just a really easy way to change the color of anything in your scene very quickly without having to do a bunch of stuff in some other program. Well, sometimes it works for you. And get that last frame. There we go. Okay, so if I disable the mask, we can see if we did a job well done or if I lose my job. So we're just scrubbing on through and it looks fabulous. You would never even be able to tell that anything around there had been shifted. You'd never be able to tell that we changed the color of the car. Now, something to note is as she gets right to the edge of the van there, she starts to turn a little blue. So we will be able to just add a keyframe here and shift that in just a little bit. And hopefully that'll solve our problem. There we go. All right. I think that shot is done. And a marvelous job it is. Well, as you know, with every tutorial channel, this is the part where they ask you to give it a like and to subscribe if you haven't already, if you enjoyed this tutorial and want to see more. I'll be coming out with a new video every Wednesday. We'll just get the ball rolling on these Final Cut Pro tutorials. I'll probably be doing a lot of camera tutorials and just getting a real cinematic look, working on cheap budgets with iPhones and all sorts of stuff like that. So if you're interested in that, please subscribe, like, comment any ideas you might have that you want to learn, and I'll get to as many of those as I can. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you next week. Hey friends, Dylan Bates here. Man, I'm gonna hate watching myself.